Hello, Bruna. So I welcome you back. Hello
there.
So excited because I know that you have tons of information to give us on collagen. So this is episode 3. So basically collagen is so important, not only for the skin, you know, we are in the beauty industry, but also for your gut, your bones, your collagen, hair, nails, everything. So it is necessary to intake it. Not only as a supplement, but also in food. The collagen is everything that holds us together. Now,
right.
Last two episodes, we talked about, do we need collagen? Yes, we do. What are the things that we need to be careful when we intake this collagen? Because it goes through the stomach, and the stomach does destroy a lot of stuff if the collagen is not the right one. And also part two, it was about, is it better pill, powder, liquid, bovine, marine, or vegan, all that. So that is all the information on part one and part two.
Absorbs. So yes. We talked a lot about bioavailability. That is absorbability. Yeah. Is the product in question, in this case, collagen, is it getting into the cell?
Yeah.
Does it have easy access? Is it getting past that membrane?
Yeah. And you kind of read my mind because I did not give you any of these questions because that was my first question, because I've heard last time you telling me or telling us bioavailability. So I said, I need to put that question number one. What do you mean by that?
Well, let me give you an example. Glutathione, for example, people are becoming more aware of that enzyme. Yeah. People are taking it in injections. They're taking it in a nebulizer form. Mm-hmm. And I want to caution people when they do that. Glutathione is an antioxidant enzyme that our body makes. Mm-hmm. But if you take glutathione in its full form, you actually displace your body's ability to make glutathione. So a lot of companies have come out with amino acids such as cysteine, which is required to make glutathione. Cysteine is something that has to get into the cell. And there's a protein in the cell called XC- that lets cysteine in. It acts like a door, like a turnstile, if you will. And in order for this molecule or this protein to let cysteine in, it requires that glutamate is coming in from the opposite side of that door. I know I might getting a little bit confusing for you, but this is the mechanism. It's an enzymatic action that permits the absorption of collagen. In this case, we're talking about glutathione, because if you don't have XC minus and glutamate on the either side of that door to make that door work, you can take as much cysteine as you want. It's not going to do anything. So it's important to remember, does your product have a delivery system that works, or are they just capitalizing on the collagen craze? I'm very fond of publicly traded companies, only because they're audited and vetted by government third-party validators. Mm-hmm. And they make the effort to be public, to be transparent. And to me, that's something that is very important in a company, especially if I'm going to be using their product.
Okay, so I have a question that I'm just going to come out to you. In your opinion, Bruna, which is the best collagen?
Well, again, we discussed transparency. We discussed delivery. And I'd like to show you my favorite through a little PowerPoint, because we talk about being transparent. So let's do a little bit of transparent. So let me just share my screen here.
Okay.
Credit to the two doctors that put this information together. One is Dr. Sean McKee. She is a physician from Biloxi, Mississippi.
Okay.
And also Dr. Zveta Silverman is a pathologist from Alberta, Canada. So I want to make sure I give them the credit for the information that you're about to see.
Thank you.
Yep, for sure. Absolutely. The little red flower that you see on the left of your screen there is a ruby red quinoa, and it is the mechanism. And I'm going to give you some transparent information as to why this is working so well. First of all, it's an activation hero, we call it, because it allows that system of absorption for the collagen. Let me give you a little bit of information about this red quinoa and what it's able to do. It helps keep bad cholesterol levels low. It maintains heart health. The high manganese content helps to regulate blood sugar levels and maintain strong and healthy bones. The iron content is used by the body to transport oxygen, and lysine found in the red quinoa helps with tissue repair and growth.
So we can eat this.
Yes, definitely.
Okay.
Eat it. It's not as accessible as the black and white, but definitely you can find it in special health food stores and definitely eat it. Make it part of your diet.
Okay.
The extract from this grain unlocks the cell's ability to absorb collagen. Just like we explained that collagen mechanism, the glutathione mechanism just before, yes. This activates the natural collagen synthesis in our cells.
Okay.
The peer review. Let me just briefly touch on peer review because it's very significant and it's something that people don't understand. When companies put their studies through a peer review process, it's time consuming.
Yes.
It's expensive. And you're subjecting yourself to people saying, no, your studies are not well outlined. It brings up unwarranted claims. It brings up things like interpretations of the studies. And that is what I mean when I'd like to see transparent peer-reviewed documents. So I hope that explains it briefly.
Yes. Yes.
This study in 2022 has that peer review process. These results were submitted for that process in a randomized, double-blind, and placebo-controlled. So we had 30 subjects, age 30 to 55. Half of them got a placebo and half of them got the real thing. 8 weeks. Well, I'd want the real thing myself.
I want the real thing too.
Yes. 8 weeks, one bottle a day. Skin conditions and blood catalase levels were monitored. Skins were evaluated at the beginning, after a month, and after 8 weeks. And the blood was taken at the beginning and after the 2 months passed.
Okay.
The skin measurements were, you see this the chart there. This is the areas that they measured. The skin moisture. Now here, I like to point out, they measured five areas of the skin, but they used different tools. And you can look these up, what they are. And you can see that they all do a little bit of everything, but they've taken these because they have a special emphasis on this particular analysis. So the skin moisture was measured with a corneometer, measures the moisture of the skin. Okay. The color was measured with a chromometer, which measures pigment, also measures erythema. Skin texture was measured with a visual analysis. And you'll remember this. We used to put people inside the screen with the blue light. The dry patches, the oily patches, and where it needed work. The crow's feet, the depth of the crow's feet was measured with a soft plus device. Mm-hmm. And the collagen density was determined via a Dermalab series skin lab combo, which is the new technology that actually goes deep into the skin to show you exactly how the density is increasing.
Mm-hmm.
Very, very cool
tool. Very cool. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. So this results were here. So the P system here. Look at the skin moisture and increase by 14%. And what this number means is out of 10,000 people, 9,999 would have had the same result.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. The brightness is 4% and the skin texture improved by 10% with trend towards significance. So obviously it was only 8 weeks, so it would get better and better, and no reports of irritation or other discomfort of any sorts. This is a photo of the Visia tool, which shows you your roughness, your texture, and you're able to see improvement. And you can see that after 8 weeks, it was a 10% improvement. I just want to show you those photos because it's kind of cool to look at.
That is cool. Yeah.
The crow's feet significantly decreased by 21.5. 100% of the participants noted a reduction in crow's feet. And these are two of the patients at week zero and at week eight. You can see the first picture on two different patients and the end. And it also shows you the decrease in the depth of the crow's feet. This is the best, right? So this uses a high frequency tool, which shows you the collagen density. At week zero was at 30.5, at week four, 57.5, and at week eight, 68.5. And the yellow dots are showing the increase in collagen. So look at the first photo. There's a lot of black spots there, lot of green. But as you look at the last photo at week eight, there's a lot more yellow. There's a lot more collagen density. So this is exciting to me. These are studies that are peer reviewed. These are looked at by a third party validator said, yeah, these are good evaluations. Blood catalase. Taking the blood is significant. Catalase, like glutathione, is an antioxidant enzyme that really fights off free radicals. And we basically break down because of free radical damage and oxidative stress. If we can increase our body's natural protection, then we slow down aging. And in this case, the blood catalase levels, just by taking collagen, increased by 202%. And 93% of the participants had increased blood catalase levels. So practically everyone. So oxidative stress is a new buzzword for free radical damage, right? The major cause of age-related everything, not just skin condition, age-related every type. There's over 400 different diseases on PubMed right now, which is the public medical library for the National Institutes of Health, that link oxidative stress to all kinds of health conditions. Nrf2 activation, I know you've talked about that, reduces oxidative stress and upregulates our survival genes, SOD, glutathione, and catalase. And that is our body's ability to fight off free radical damage on the skin, in the organs, everywhere. And if you look at that second picture underneath there, the collagens, we've got five there. Collagen 7, collagen 9, collagen 14, and 3-in-1. So it's not just 1, 2, and 3, the basic ones, but the other collagens, they hold that structure together. And it's important that we take more than maybe just 1, 2, and 3, because we have, that we know of, 28 different types of collagen. There may be more. The ruby red quinoa. How did we prove that it was working? There was an in vitro gene activation with red quinoa. Human skin fibroblasts were treated with and without it, so some with, some without. The fibroblasts that were treated with the red quinoa address these particular genes, and you might want to take a screenshot and look them up. But TGM1, KRT1, and KRT10, they are for your epidermal barrier, the structure, the strength, the resilience. SOD, we just talked about, superoxide dismutase, is an antioxidant gene that helps fight off free radicals. COL1A2 is a gene that provides instruction to the cell to make type 1 collagen. And MMP9, which we don't want that, is an enzyme engaged in the degradation or the breaking down of collagen. The results, the things, the genes that we wanted to upregulate, up by 2 to 5%, SOD by 27%. The gene expression of COL1A2, which is responsible for making type 1 collagen, increased by 43%. And the enzyme that is responsible for breaking down collagen was downregulated by 33%. Let me show you a couple of photos here.
Oh, yes.
Got them on here. Yeah, those are the best part. So these are some gentlemen. Now, these are unadulterated photos. They're just selfies. But you can see that even with a selfie and not proper lighting, you can see a significant change in these skins.
Yes.
Body,
Wow.
legs, arms. You can see that the denseness in the arm and the structure
To
is
the
sort of
arm.
filling in, right? That tension is increasing.
Firmness.
And the firmness, and it's for all over. All over the, I'm impressed with this belly photo. Look at that. Everybody has a little bit of that. One or two kids, and voila, that happens. And this is able to increase the youthful glow. We want that. And imagine if it's happening here on the skin, because the skin we talked about is the least important organ, right? You can live without
Yes.
your skin. Imagine what's happening to your organs inside.
Oh, yeah. There we go.
All right.
So I have another question. So I can see from these studies why this true science liquid collagen is amazing. But give me some more information, Bruna.
Let's see, why is it working so well? In my opinion, it is the hydrolyzation, the broken down peptides. It is the 10 types of collagen with a proven delivery system. That's the key. It's not just one or two or three collagens, it's 10 different ones that can address all the different collagens that is required to create that strong tense matrix. And also, in my opinion, the liquid form is the way to go. It's the most absorbable. It doesn't need to be broken down. It doesn't need to be mixed with anything. And the body just creates a, it absorbs. We know now that we talked about how they proved that it did make it past the stomach acids and it was able to arrive at the destination, the particular cells. So yeah, those are the three things that I would say, this is the reason why this is working. I just like to give data, transparency. This is why this works. This is why we choose it.
Well, Bruna, this short little video or tutorial was amazing. Thank you so much for your time, because your time is very valuable. And I really appreciate you being here with me and us. And I'm sure that we're going to get a lot of questions, and maybe we'll have episode number 4.
Well, you know what? I'm honored to be here, and I want to thank the viewers for taking the time to listen to us chatter away here. So thank you. Thank you for your time, and I hope to be asked again.
Absolutely. Take care, Bruna.
Take care.